Yes, no, yes?
Yes.
Perfect. All right. Fizz-Buzz, 5 minutes, 29 slides, I think. Let's do this. What is Fizz-Buzz? Who here knows what Fizz-Buzz is? Is it a children's game, a teaching aid, a drinking game, a cocktail, or a programming exercise?
Yes.
Shout it out, what do you think it is?
Yes.
And of course the answer is yes. Except the cocktail, that's Buck Fizz. So here's how you play. Here's the modern version of how you play. In turns, you count up from one, but if a number's divisible by three, you say Fizz. If a number's divisible by five, you say Buzz. And if it's divisible by both three and five, you say Fizz-Buzz. And if you hesitate or misspeak, you are out, or you lose a point, or you take a drink, or you pay some forfeit. So where does this come from? I got really far down a rabbit hole researching this over the last 11, 12 months. As early as 1832, we find it in the little girl's own book, where we find a precursor, the game of Buzz. Count up from one, and if a number is divisible by seven, or it contains the digit seven, you say Buzz. And when you get to the 70s, you say buzz one, and so on, up to buzz buzz for 77. In 1852, we find its use as a teaching aid in the Book of Children's Games, which describes the game of fuzz buzz. Similar rules to buzz, but with nine instead of seven, and when you get to 99, you say fuzz buzz. How very exciting. 1864, it shows up as a drinking game in the slang dictionary. And it also comes with this weirdly complex version called Snooks-and-Walker. You say Snooks if it's divisible by three or contains digit three, Walker for five. This is the only book that this game appears in, and it disappeared from the later editions as well. I don't know why, I guess it just never really took off. 1867, the Home Book of Pleasure and Instruction, or a wonderfully titillating title, describes the classical game of Buzz and adds in a footnote, this game may be made much more amusing by saying Fizz instead of five in its multiples, thus 57 would be Fizz Buzz. In 1897, we get Dracula from Bram Stoker. Now, this has nothing to do with Fizz-Buzz, but given that Fizz-Buzz has been established by this point, and vampires have this thing about counting, it would be both historically plausible and in character for Dracula to play Fizz-Buzz, and I want somebody to write that adaptation. In 1921, at the Bugs Club in London, the Bugs Fizz cocktail is invented. Allegedly. I couldn't actually find a definitive source for this one. The earliest I could find in print was the 1930 Savoy cocktail book, which describes in a beautifully terse nine words and one fraction, use long tumbler, quarter glass orange juice, fill with champagne. 1958, the Country Guide gives us a very confused version of the game, which, if I've understood their wording correctly, you say buzz if the number's divisible by five, and fizz if it's two more than a multiple of five. I can only assume that they saw the first three terms of five, seven, and ten, and extrapolated it very wrongly. In 1982, 150 years after the first appearance of buzz that I could find, it shows up on computers in figure fun for the Atari 400. In this version, you pick which numbers are Fizz and which is Buzz, and then it will throw random numbers at you, and you have to quickly declare whether it's Fizz, Buzz, or neither. In 1997, it shows up in this Java textbook as a programming example, and then in 2007, Imran Ghori posts this now infamous blog post suggesting that we use it as a hiring test for programmers. If you can't write a simple Fizz, Buzz program, are you worth hiring? I don't think it's a great test, but it is what it is. And 2023, you're in this room. History in the making. This is just the surface. This is the tip of the iceberg. I have spent the last 11 months researching this. I have found over 100 historical references, various different versions of this. Tried to cram as much as I could into 5 minutes. I have a copy of the Little Girl's Own Book, the 1832 one. I have a modern reprint. You're welcome to come and read. I have a few of the others at home as well. That's all I got. Thank you.